Hi, and welcome to another episode of Patents TV. I'm your new host, Jenna Fallbush. As today is the third Tuesday of the month, I bring you Equals Mathematics, a K-12 standards-based curriculum by AbleNet Incorporated, which is our featured solution for January. To get started, Karen Ross Brown is going to tell you a little bit about the development of Equals Math.
I'm here to talk to you about Equals Mathematics curriculum, a curriculum that was specifically designed for students with mild, moderate, and severe profound disabilities. If we are going to teach math to students with disabilities, it makes sense to provide instruction that is meaningful and complete, that allows us to raise expectations of our students and supports their unique needs. Of course, we want math lessons to be motivating, interesting, and engaging, and ultimately teach students how to think about math and solving problems. We want to focus on teaching math skills in context, which is what a true curriculum does. In every lesson, you will see the lesson objective is demonstrated to the students in a concrete way with hands-on manipulatives, in a semi-concrete way, such as with picture symbols representing those concrete items, and in an abstract way with numbers and symbols that you typically see in math.
Now let's see Equals Math at work in the classroom.
Count nine. Keep going.
Six.
Four.
Five.
Keep going.
Six.
Come on, scoop.
Seven. Eight. Nine.
Good job. Nine butterflies. Give me five.
All right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Nine.
Good job, Nate.
Nine.
All right, guys. Good job. Now we're going to do it on our number line. Okay? Watch me first. We're counting to
nine.
Ready? Do we count this one?
Yeah.
Zero? Mm-mm. Ready? Zero means?
Stop.
Nothing.
Nothing.
All right. One.
Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine.
Stop. All right. Good job, guys. We counted to?
Nine.
All right.
Today, our friend Marnie is very, very hungry. Did you guys have snack already?
No.
Did you have snack this morning?
No.
No? So you're hungry too. Are you hungry? Well, when you're really hungry, do you want a little bit of food or do you want a lot of food? A lot of food, right? Well, you want more? Very good. All right. Well, today it's snack time. And Marnie's teacher brought in French fries. Who likes French fries?
Me.
I love French fries. Do you like French fries, Brandon?
Yes.
You like French fries too? All right. Well, Marnie is very hungry. So her teacher is going to give her two different plates with food on them. And we have to help Marnie so that Marnie gets the plate with more.
More.
All right.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. You want to start, Kamari? All right. So Marnie has two plates. If you're going to give your friend Marnie some French fries, which one is the plate with more? Very good. Nice job. Let's count those French fries, okay?
Two.
Good job. All right, Jonathan, are you ready?
Two.
Oh, all right. Very good. This is number two, and you have how many fries? One.
Two.
Very good. So how many do we have?
Two.
Very good. Number two. Great job.
We are working on numbers five and
six.
You're right. Five and six.
And I'm going to do something like this.
We are going to do things with numbers five and six. What number is that one?
Five.
And what number is that one?
6.
Good. What do you see?
6.
And what do you see?
5.
5, like 5 fingers. Show me your 5 fingers. Show me your 5 fingers. Show me your 5 fingers, Sarah. Good. What number is that?
5.
And what number is that?
5.
Try again. 6. Good job. 5 and 6. And we're going to look at our ocean poster, and we're going to show and tell some things we see on our ocean poster. Things that are in numbers 5 and 6. Sets of 5. Do you see, how big is this set? What is the amount of that set? Why don't you count it up for me?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Oh, is that a set or 5 or 6?
Yes, I can count it even faster.
What set is it?
It's 5 and 6.
What set is this? It's a set of
6.
It's a set of 6. Let's see if our friend Brandon can show and tell us a set of 5 or 6. What about this set up here? What are those, Brandon?
Those are dolphins.
Those are dolphins. Can you count that set?
1, 2, 3, 4.
Oh, you can't see. And 1, let's see.
6.
Let's try it together. I lost count.
2, 3, 4, 5.
5 what? I see 5
dolphins.
Let's write that on our number notes. Brandon's turn. Brandon, do you see a way we can show or write 5? The 5-10 frame. That was a good one. 5-10 frame is a way we can do 5. Here we go. 5 dolphins.
It's an open.
Let's look. It says, I see 6 seashells. And here's the number 6 in dice patterns. Right, Sarah? I see 5 dolphins. Here's number 5 on a 10 frame.
Oh,
okay. Oh, okay, you got it? Let's see. Where's the number 5? What?
5.
Good job. We're going to add the number 5 right here. Good job. Let's read our number notes poster for the day. You ready?
Yeah.
It says, I see
6
seashells. And look, we did the number 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I see 5
dolphins.
Number 5, like give me 5. Right? Show me, give me 5. There you go. And we have the 5-10 frame. And Sarah showed us 5 fish on the poster. Let's count them for Sarah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And we wrote the words 5 fish. Good job.
Okay.
Okay, good job.
Okay.
You did it.
Is this. Drew is a girl. And Drew, she wants to use the math line. But the math line is mixed up with all kinds of other math tools. And so Drew needs our help to find the math line.
Oh.
Is this the math line? Actually, no. Exactly, Ahmed. You didn't even get a chance to check it out. Check it out, Ahmed. Is that the math line? Nope, that is not the math line. You are right. Is this the math line? Let's see. A math line we were able to count. 1, 2, 3. So this is the math line. She will not be able to find the math line unless we help her again. Here's the math line. Guess what happened? It got buried. I need help finding the math line. First you need to look, then touch. What is that? You found the math line. 1, 2, 3. Good job. Thank you. Good looking. Find that math line. Get it out of there. I am so used to saying I'm a special educator. I put together my own curriculum. It is so nice to have a curriculum that's intact. That's an exciting part to the Equals Math program. Another exciting part is it's equal access for all of my students, no matter what skill level they are starting with. I know that they are going to be gaining in their skills. And sure, it might come out in other ways. It might come out more in their social skills or their attending skills, their communication skills, but it is all tied to math. And it is an equal access with their general ed peers in that we are all learning math together.
For more information on Equals Math, visit our website, patentsproject.com, and click on Featured Solution under the Services tab. Thanks for tuning in. See you next time on Patents TV.